This is Sonal from USA and welcome to my channel. Who are here for the first time, my channel is all about lifestyle in US, information, food and travel. So I just bring different kind of information on this channel so people who are aspiring to come to USA can look at my videos and understand what is the lifestyle, what to expect here and what are the things that are happening, what is the visa, etc. So all around the US. So today I'm going to talk about the changes that Trump administration made for the H-1B visa. So these H-1 new policies are issued as a new interim rules. Now what does that mean? That means that it will take effect without first undergoing the public comments or opinions and there would not be initial review. But there is also a 60 days time frame where people can sue this or take this to the court for further evaluation and try to minimize the impact. Who would do that? The most techie companies. So you're not alone in this boat as an H-1B holder, but there are many techie companies who feel that this is going to impact their business and the economy. Now coming to the changes, what are those changes as H-1B that the Trump administration has made? Number one, companies will have to pay the higher wages, and probably now the H-1B holders are happy that okay, we are going to get higher wages. But look at this, the downside is if the H-1 wages are going to be higher, then the US economy as it is because of the pandemic, the economy is going down and companies are losing their business. In this scenario, if they will have to hire the H-1B workforce at a higher pay, they will not be able to afford that. And basically that is the purpose, that if the higher wages have to be paid to the H-1B workers, then companies would think to replace American workforce with the H-1B workforce, and that is the whole objective. So and to give the comparison, if a software engineer was starting at say X level, now he has to start at this level. So in terms of percentile, if the software developer was making say compensation or salary at a 15% percentile, now he has gone to 45th percentile. So you can see the jump that company will have to make because it's a role now. And the higher technology skills or highly skilled workers who were at 67% now has gone to the 95 percentile of the salary. So it's a huge significant jump that the employer will have to pay if they are hiring H-1B workers as a fresher or highly skilled workers. And as you can see or understand, it is next to kind of impossible or very difficult or very tough for the techie companies, because most of the techie companies rely on H-1B workforce for the highly technical skills like artificial intelligence, bioinformation, and any technological skills that you think about, they think of bringing H-1B workforce, and most of them come from India, China, most of them are from Asia. So as of now, this is the first change where they're talking about the higher pay. Now let's look at the second one. So second change that has been done is they have changed the definition of the specialty occupation. Now what does that mean? It looks a little complex, but it is not that complex. So earlier, anybody who had the higher degree and experience was able to apply for the H-1B to come here and work into the software development. But now with this change, they are going to see that your degree has to be in that specialized field to work into particular fields. So if you have to work as a software developer and if you have an electrical or electronics degree, you will not be able to apply for H-1B visa. So it has to be into the related field. So if you have to work in software development, you have to have that relevant degree when you are applying for H-1B visa, otherwise you will not be able to apply. So this is how they have changed the specialty occupation, basically specialty occupation definition. So that is how they have changed it, and it is going to impact because many of our employees or many of the people who are working in the software industry not necessarily come from the same background. They might have done the mechanical engineering or civil engineering, and I've seen that many people after doing engineering, they just consider that as a basic degree, and then they do the development courses or they join IT companies where they get trained on different softwares or different technologies, and then they start working in IT. So now that is going to be very focused, and there will be scrutiny, of course, to see that, you know, specialty occupation guys or employees are from the particular field or have that particular degree. So this is another major change. The third change that they are talking about is the employer-employee relationship. Now, what does that mean? Employer-employee relationship, where they are going to see that the employer who is filing is a real employer, and the employee who is for whom the H-1B is filed is a real employee. What does that mean? That means that they are going to scrutinize more and more the relationship between the manager and the H-1B visa holder to see that that person has a direct control over him and he is working for him, and whatever product or services he is developing are monitored by this supervisor. So this is the employer-employee relationship that I'm talking about. And the fourth one is the duration. So the duration of the H-1B visa is normally, once you get an approval, it's for 3 years, right? So with this rule, now what will happen is the duration is only 1 year. So that means, and that's not for all the companies, product companies it may not impact, but for especially for the consulting companies, and there are many consulting companies here, IT companies which are consulting to other professional companies. So if somebody is working on H-1B for a consulting company, there are many consulting companies, like I said, for example Infosys, then Cognizant, then TCS, these are all the consulting firms, Hexaware, Syntel, Wipro. So these consulting firms, when they bring H-1B workers, these H-1B workers actually work for other companies, or we call them customers, right? And they get 3 years work visa. But now with this, their extension would be only for, or their duration will be only for 1 year. That means the employer will have to constantly renew it every year. That would cause more strain to the employer and to the employee. So these are the four major changes which have brought by the Trump administration. And as I said in the beginning, they are interim order. So that means there is still a chance that within 60 days, some IT companies may appeal for this, and there might be some less burden, or some things may not get impacted immediately and would be re-evaluated. But at this point in time, yes, these are some changes. As an H-1B holder, probably you are stressed, and some of you are happy that, oh wow, I'm going to get now higher wages. But mind well that it is not for the existing H-1B visa holders. It's only for the people who are going to file new H-1B visa. So if your visa is under renewal, you will not get the higher wages. It's only for the people who are going to file it new would get those higher wages. But as I said, with the pandemic, the economy is moving so slow that companies will not be able to afford a fresher or a junior level person or a resource at such a higher pay or higher wages. And same is the case for the highly skilled workers, where they will not be able to place them with such a high compensation. So there is going to be impact, and we'll wait and see what happens. Definitely read this news in detail, how it is impacting, and if any questions, of course, you can write in the comments. So if you're not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel, Sonal from USA, and if you like this video, thumbs up to banta hai. Alright, and also press on that bell icon so that you will get notification next time when I upload a new video. So till we meet next time. Bye-bye.